India is behind in some aspect from many developed countries, but India has proved its mettle in terms of space. Friends, you all have seen the picture circulated on the internet that the two person carrying a rocket behind the cycle. Friends, the rocket name was Nike Apache of USA that was launched in the year 1963 from Thiruvananthapuram. Taking the rocket on the cycle to launching the orbiter to Mars in low cost show the capability of ISRO. Not only this, despite of having technological backwardness and budget crunch, today ISRO is one of the most successful and best space agency in the world. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ajay and today I'll convey my lectureate on Indian Space Program. Friends, Indian Space Program was started in the year 1963 when Vikram Sarabhai has established a SSTC, that is Science Space Technological Center, and from there the Indian Space Program continuously going good. As India, as Vikram Sarabhai, with the help of Baba Jahangir, established ISRO in the year 1969 with the help of Prime Minister Indira Gandhi. Friends, in the year 1975, India launched its own satellite named Aryabhata with the help of USSR space agency Intercosmos. Not only this, India developed its satellite launch vehicle SLV in 1978, and from that, with the help of SLV, India launched its own satellite named Rohini Series 1 satellite in 1980. Not only this, in the year 1983, India started working on polar satellite launch vehicle as India faced the need of the heavy satellites to launch in the space, and that takes out the PSLV development. As in the year 1995, India completed the in the year 1992-1995, India has completed the work on and development of the PSLV, and from there India has boomed the space. India has boomed its space program. Development of PSLV was ISRO's major achievement, as it gives Indian space program a major boost. Either it is Chandrayaan 1 or it is Mangalyaan mission, or it is carrying 104 satellites of the different nation, PSLV showed its success, and also it has now become the backbone of the ISRO. Friends, ISRO with the help of PSLV launched many satellites with main focus of multi-band communication, radar imaging, optical imaging and meteorological satellites. In 1983, ISRO launched INSAT-1B and INSAT satellite for telecommunication, television broadcasting, weather forecasting and disaster management. Not only this, during the Kargil war in 1999, India asked for the GPS system, for the access of GPS system, and USA denied it, and that came to for the need of the own GPS system, and and after 16 years ISRO launched its own GPS system named as NAVIC, that is navigation with Indian constellation, focus on Indian surveillance within the range of 1500 kilometers, and this gives the capability to Indian armed forces to track the enemy up to the 5 meter. Not only this, ISRO RISAT, that is radar imaging satellite, is helping Indian armed forces in border surveillance, insurgent infiltration and anti-terrorist operation. With the help of CartoSat of Earth Observation Satellite, India is able to execute in remote sensing program, which is helpful in resource management and monitoring of Earth. EMISAT, that is electronic surveillance satellite, placed in electronic surveillance satellite, which is helping in maritime application satellite. Moreover, it also shares the position of hostile country radar, which gives situational awareness to armed forces. ISRO, after launching GSAT-7, provided capabilities to Indian armed forces in oceanic regions as well as Indian landmass. GSAT-7 was mainly made for Navy and ISRO differently made GSAT-7A for Indian Armed Forces and Indian Army. The main achievement of ISRO came in the year 2019 when the ISRO and DRDO conducted Mission Shakti when they developed the capability to destroy the hostile satellite in space. Not only this, friends, ISRO has some futuristic projects. Let us see the futuristic project of ISRO. ISRO in the year 2018 has developed the SSLV vehicle, that is small satellite launch vehicle to launch the satellites that is of medium and small sizes, as it was earlier taking the more cost through the PSLV. So that bring the idea to reduce the cost through the help of SSLV. Chandrayaan 3, as we are aware, as we know that during the Chandrayaan 2 mission, that meet with the technological fault and the rover which was sent to the moon was not came out from the launch vehicle. So that brings the idea to go ahead with the Chandrayaan 3 and make it successful. As in ISRO, in the Chandrayaan 1, conducted the research on the moon and founded the ice water in the Chandrayaan 1 mission. So to carry forward the mission, the Chandrayaan 3 mission has been taken by the ISRO. Not only this, Gaganyaan mission is also been marked by the ISRO, as ISRO is conducting the training of the IAF pilot for sending them to the moon. ISRO is focusing to send the satellite near to the sun to conduct the research of the outer sphere of sun, that is corona and chromosphere, and also to analyze and collect data of solar storm and magnetic field of the sun. Not only this, ISRO has completed the work of Samudriyan, that is to conduct a deep ocean research with the help of humans. In the last, I would like to say that the ISRO in the small bit of time is now competing with the main and with leading space agency, that is NASA, European Space Agency, Japan Space Agency and Chinese Space Agency, and also prove its mettle. Not only this, ISRO also inspired the world with low-cost satellite and become very successful space agency. Earlier, ISRO work only on 1 to 2 projects, but now ISRO aim has now been converted to the aspirations and ambition, which is developing India and securing India from the hostile country. Thank you.